Welcome to Differentiation Techniques. Today we'll be covering the constant rule, the power rule, the constant multiple rule, and the sum and difference rule. The goal of this video will be to find derivatives using the rules mentioned above. I'd like to start by taking a look at the graph. Here we have the graph of a constant function. What we're going to do is we're going to plot the values of the derivatives at various points. So when we start to animate this point, you can see in red it's graphing the value of the derivative at the corresponding x value. Remember, the value of the derivative would be the slope of the tangent line at that given x value. And what we see here is that the derivative is always equal to zero at any point on a horizontal line. And hopefully that makes sense. If I was to pick a point on the horizontal line and sketch a tangent line, of course it would be the same line with a slope of zero. Which brings us to our first derivative rule, the constant rule. The derivative of a constant is zero. That is, if c is a real number, then the derivative of c with respect to x will equal zero. A couple quick examples. The derivative of 5 with respect to x would be zero. The derivative of pi with respect to x would be zero. Remember, pi is also a constant. Next, we're going to look at the power rule, but first I want to go back and take a look at some graphs and see if we can see a pattern between a function and its derivative. Between a function and its derivatives. In this case, we're looking at a line. Remember, a line is a degree 1 function. As we animate this point, again, the derivative will be plotted in red. And we can see the pattern here. We have a degree 1 function, and the derivative is degree 0. If we look at a degree 2 function, or a quadratic function, and plot its derivative in red, we can see that a degree 2 function has a degree 1 derivative. If I pause at this point, we can see the derivative has a value of negative 2, which would represent the slope of this tangent line. Let's go ahead and take a look at a degree 3 function. We'll animate the point and plot the derivative. So here's a degree 3 function, and we can see that the derivative is a quadratic or a degree 2. Again, if I was to pause the tangent line, let's say right here at x equals negative 2, the value of the red function, looks like it would be negative 12, would tell us the slope of our tangent line. So we kind of see a pattern here. Let's summarize the pattern that we've just seen. The power rule. If n is a rational number, then the function is differentiable, and the derivative of x to the power of n with respect to x is equal to n times x to the power of n minus 1. So to find the derivative, we multiply by our current exponent, and then our new exponent we have to subtract 1. We saw the degree of the functions we graphed decreased by 1 when we found its derivative. This rule does verify the patterns that we saw. Now, of course, we could prove this formula by using the limit definition of derivative. If you look at any calculus textbook, most of the proofs will be in there. If you're curious, I would encourage you to look at it. Okay, the derivative of x to the power of 5 would be equal to 5 will be the coefficient, and the new exponent will be 5 minus 1, so our derivative would be 5x to the power of 4. Now, these next two examples do not fit the form of this formula, so what we're going to have to do is rewrite this so that it does fit. What I mean by that is we have to recognize that the cube root of x is the same as x to the 1/3 power. So our derivative would be 1/3 x to the 1/3 minus 1, which would be 1/3 x to the power of negative 2/3. Simplifying this, we would have 1 over 3. Now, if I move this to the denominator, of course, it would become x to the 2/3 power. Our original function was in radical form, so I'm going to convert it back into radical form. So this would be the cube root of x squared. This next derivative, we need to move this up into the numerator, so we would have x to the power of negative 2. Now, finding the derivative of this, it would be negative 2 times x to the power of negative 2 minus 1, which would be equal to negative 2 times x to the power of negative 3. Again, simplifying, moving the x to the negative 3 into the denominator would change the sign of the exponent. So our final answer would be negative 2 divided by x to the third. Okay, the next two rules. The next rule is the constant multiple rule. If f is a differentiable function and c is a real number, then c times f is also differentiable, and the derivative would just be c times the derivative of f of x. So what this formula is saying, if I want to find the derivative of 3x squared with respect to x, it would be 3 times the derivative of x squared. Well, the derivative of x squared would be 2x to the power of 2 minus 1, of course, would give us 1, so our derivative would be equal to 6x. On this next example, the first thing I see is there's no exponent on x. Of course, it's an implied 1, so I'll go ahead and put that in there. So the derivative of this would be equal to 1 half times the derivative of x to the first, which would be 1 times x to the 1 minus 1 would be 0. So we know that 1 half times 1 is 1 half times x to the 0, but of course x to the 0 is also 1, so our derivative is just equal to 1 half. The next rule, the sum and difference rules, the derivative of f of x plus or minus g of x with respect to x is equal to the derivative of f plus or minus the derivative of g. So essentially, if I want to find the derivative of this example, I just need to find the derivative of each term. So if I wanted to take the time, I could rewrite this as three individual derivatives. Of course, looking at the second term, I'm going to have to rewrite this in rational exponent form and also move it up to the numerator. So this is x to the 1 half in the denominator. If I move it up, we're going to have 5x to the power of negative 1 half minus the derivative of 8. Now sometimes we'll skip this step, but I'll show it here. Now we'll apply the power rule to each of these terms to find the derivative. So here we'd have 2 times 7x to the power of 6 minus 5 times a negative 1 half x to the power of negative 1 half minus 1 would be negative 3 halves. The derivative of 8, of course, would be 0. Let's simplify. We'd have 14x to the 6th plus 5 halves x to the negative 3 halves power. Again, we can move this to the denominator to make it a positive exponent. So to simplify this, I'll move the x to the denominator to make it x to the power of 3 halves. Okay, I hope that helps explain some basic derivative rules. Thank you for watching. My next video will deal with applications of these rules.